But yes. Before we go to the Word of God,
pero antes de entrar a la palabra del Señor,
in case there is anybody here,
en caso que hay alguien aquí,
who has not committed his or her life to the Lord, today we will give an opportunity to do so.
Que no le ha dado su vida completamente al Señor hoy, que quisiéramos dar esta oportunidad.
Without Christ in life, life is hopeless and helpless.
Sin Cristo en la vida no tiene sentido, no hay esperanza en la vida.
If Jesus is not in your heart,
si Jesús no está en tu
corazón, today you can receive him into your heart. Jesus, God who commanded, let there be light, that light Jesus can come to your life. Or if there is anybody who has received Jesus but gone away from the Lord. Or if you are not sure, if you die today, where will you go? And if you are not sure, you don't need to leave the world in that state. Jesus can really brighten up your life. In case you are backslidden and if you are not sure whether you will go to heaven or hell, you don't need to be in that double mind or a difficult state. Today Jesus can really come into your life. Life can really be changed. What the money and materials and mansions cannot give, Jesus can give. Shall we all stand up? We are going to pray. And I want everyone to join to pray. And as we want to pray, as the eyes are closed, if there is anybody who wants to receive Jesus into your heart, or if you are gone away from the Lord and you want to come back to the Lord, I want you to just raise your hand. We want to pray for you. You can receive Jesus into your heart. Or he can be restored into your heart. As we are praying, will you raise your hand, those who want to receive him into your heart? Anybody who wants to receive, you can raise your hand. We are going to pray now. Make sure that you receive the Lord into your life. Shall we all close our eyes? While we are closing our eyes, anybody who wants to receive or restore Jesus, please keep your hands raised. Loving Heavenly Father, we praise and thank you for this time, Lord. If there is anybody here, O God, who, Lord, is lost state, or Lord, sins need to be forgiven today on this resurrection morning, O God, let the Lord Jesus Christ become very real to them. Lord, if anybody here, Lord, in a backslidden state, today, let the precious blood of Jesus come and restore them, we pray you, Father. Lord, as Jesus was raised from the dead, Lord, those who are in dead state, spiritually dead in trespasses and sins, let them be resurrected. Lord, to receive Christ, we pray. Lord, we pray for all the dear ones who came, Lord, the children of God. You will bless them today. Let thy word, Lord, bring light and life into every one of us. In Jesus' name. Thank you. You may please be seated. It is possible that quite a number of our young people may go from this meeting about 1 o'clock. So don't be disturbed about it because they have to go to the hospital ministry. We all believe that Jesus was raised from the dead. But perhaps some of us may not realize what a great blessing that the resurrection of Christ brought for us, all of us. There are so many blessings to the resurrection of Jesus. As God gives me grace, I would like to mention one aspect of that. And I want to tell you, the blessings of resurrection are not just a small or ordinary. When our lives are really, our eyes are opened, it can really help us. We'll quickly go to the Word of God. Shall we read Philippians? Somebody may take the microphone and read Philippians chapter 2, verse 9 to 11.
Wherefore God also hath highly exalted him, and given him a name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, of things in heaven and things in earth and things under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father.
This is spoken of Christ after his resurrection. After resurrection, what happened? Wherefore God hath highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name. So today, what the Lord laid in my heart to mention about the greatness, the power of the name of the Lord. After resurrection, Father gave him a name which is above every name. That at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow. Of things in heaven, and things in earth, and things under the earth. And that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Before we go to this, the power in the name of the Lord Jesus, I would like to mention one day how my spiritual eyes were open to understand the power in the name of Jesus. And I believe that if we know the power in the name of Jesus, we will be different people altogether. When we read the Father gave him a name, we may not realize what is that. Beloved ones, if we read, oh, Father gave him a throne, a crown, we may understand. At least little. But Father gave him a name above all names. And at the name of Jesus, heaven, earth and hell all have to bow. Many years ago in a particular faith home, sometime in the forenoon, our telephone rang. On the other side, a drunken man was speaking. Somebody had given him, some of our church people had given him a tract. In that tract, he found our telephone number. So he told me that he was standing very near to a bridge. Somewhere on a telephone booth, he was just, he had put a coin and he was calling. He told, I am just going to commit suicide now. I am near the bridge. I had my liquor bottle is with me. And life has no meaning. Because of my drunken state, my wife left me. My child is dying with a hole in the heart. Obviously, he was drug addict also. As he was about to plunge into the water, he felt with the coin that he had just make a call. When this was told to me, My heart lifted up to heaven. Lord, what shall I do for him? In few minutes he will be dead and go. This is not the time to preach about salvation. The coin he might have put may perhaps in a minute or two it may finish and that will be the end. Maybe in the drunken state he may not even realize if I try to take a Bible verse by the time perhaps the phone may be cut off. Lord, what my, as he was mentioning, suddenly my heart was lifted up to heaven. My heart was crying. Then something beautiful happened. The Lord told, take my name. And that's it. And I commanded, I didn't speak to him. I commanded in the name of Jesus, throw away that bottle. I commanded in the name of Jesus, I rebuke the spirit of suicide. In the name of Jesus, go home now. I just mentioned, kept on mentioning in the name of Jesus. All what I told, in the name of Jesus, do this. In the name of Jesus, go. In the name of Jesus, this and that. Exactly, I don't remember. But that day, dear ones, it just a glimpse came upon me from heaven. Take my name. And then I didn't hear afterwards what happened. From other side, then after, everything stopped. So, although that anointing and power, the name of Jesus was enlightened, but afterwards I didn't know what happened. I think I didn't know the name of the person. I didn't know where he lived. Nothing I knew afterwards. Today is this Easter Sunday. And that year, Easter Sunday, after the Sunday service in that place, one young man came forward. And he told, Pastor, I was the person for whom you prayed that day. I was about to commit suicide. Oh, that greatly relieved my heart. Anyway, to cut short the story, I was privileged to baptize him. He accepted the Lord. He stood for the truth. He received the Holy Spirit. That day, beloved ones, I knew what is the tremendous power in the name of Jesus. Oh, the devil. What do we read? I would like all of us to read together this verse. You wouldn't be surprised while you are reading. Perhaps you may be healed. Maybe you might have come with some certain fear. The fear will go. Maybe you have some great problem as you read, realizing the power in the name of Jesus. Something can happen to you. The name of Jesus has been approved by heaven. It is the most powerful name in heaven, on earth and in hell. At the name of Jesus, it doesn't say in the presence of Jesus, at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. Whatever language Bible you have, Philippians chapter 2, verse 9 to 11, we are going to read loud and clear. I want to tell you, once you know the power in the name of Jesus, powers of hell will be shaken. And you will find you are a brand new man. You know what is the power of resurrection? When Jesus was resurrected, the Father gave him a name. Many people, if it is written, Father gave him some treasure, we may understand quickly. It is very unique. God willing, I am so excited to mention about the name of Jesus. So we are going to read it. If you believe, while reading itself, God can do a miracle for us. Yes. From the 9th verse, are you ready to read now? Wherefore, God also hath highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow, of things in heaven and things in earth and things under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Shall we praise God for that? Hallelujah! Amen! Thank you, Jesus! Name above every name! Hallelujah! 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 Amen! Amen! Thank you, Jesus! Hallelujah! Beloved ones, cancer is just a name. Oh, asthma is just a name. Any sickness is just a name. At the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. He is given a name above all other names. Beloved ones, it is so marvelous. Fear is just a name. But the name of Jesus is far above all other names. It has got such a magnetic power. What in short I wanted to use, how to use the power in the name of Jesus. How to apply in our life. All the heavenly blessings in essence are deposited in the name of Jesus. I want to tell you, the saints who knew the power in the name of Jesus, they became very great saints. I read about a man of God, some of you might have heard about E.W. Kenyon. He died in 1948. He wrote a book called The Wonderful Name of Jesus, but I never read it. I heard about it. That obviously, if anyone of you have that book, I don't know whether out of print, because he died in 1948, so long before that it was printed. He mentions in that book, I have some quotations, but it mentions what the wonderful name of Jesus has done in him and in his ministry. His life and ministry had tremendous blessing because of he knew what was the power in the name of Jesus. It was a life of miracles after miracles. And finally, that he completed a book called The Heart of God. A beautiful book he had written. By that time, he was in his 80s. And his wife and daughter invited him for the morning breakfast. And he told her, I don't need to this morning breakfast. Yeah. He told, I don't need this morning breakfast. That morning, peacefully, without any sickness or headache, absolutely without any sickness, he slipped into the presence of God. Because the power in that book, I wish I had that book, it mentions what is the greatness of the power of the name of Jesus. He greatly understood. Another saint called F. of Bosworth, he also died long ago. You may find his book called Christ the Healer. And his life was so tremendous. And one main reason, he knew the power in the name of Jesus. When he was 80 years old, one day he told his family and others, "This is the most blessed day in my life. Or rather, this is the greatest day in my life." And after mentioning that, he died without any sickness. Another saint knew the power in the name of Jesus. Some of you know Pastor S.B. Ernest. How many of you know and have seen Pastor S.B. Ernest answer? Oh, his life was so tremendous. And 1987 October, he preached on Sunday in the Delhi Convention in India. It was a powerful, tremendous message. The tapes are gone all through the world. Next day, Monday, he invited the elders of the church to have a time of prayer. Till about 11 o'clock at night. Then he lay down and slept in the Lord. Without any sickness. By the way, all those who died with sickness, saints, all are safe in heaven. But, beloved ones, we must know what the Bible speaks about the power in the name of Jesus. Three ways man can get great names. This is what Kenyan says. Three ways man can get great name. One is some people are born to a great name. Born to a king, then it's automatically you get by inheritance, you get a great name. You are born as a prince. So some people get great name by inheritance or by birth. And others make their name great by their achievements. Because so many things they have done, their name may become great. Then others have a great name conferred upon them. So three ways a name can become great. Beloved ones, in these three ways, Jesus' name is great. Like a king, like a child born to a king, by inheritance, he becomes great. Jesus, by inheritance, he got an excellent name. Hebrews chapter 1. While listening to the word of God, I request you, open your heart. Word of God is true. It can do a beautiful work in your life and in my life. All power of heaven, hell, and earth, all the powers are deposited, or greater power than all these powers are deposited in the name of Jesus. Please read Hebrews chapter 1 verse 4.
Being made so much better than the angels, as he hath by inheritance obtained a more excellent name than they.
By inheritance, he obtained a more excellent name than they. We all know by birth only the inheritance comes. If you are born to a rich father, by inheritance you get some possessions. Jesus obtained a more excellent name than they by inheritance. All this speak about the power of the resurrection that later verse mentioned, but we have no time to go through. I just would like to focus our attention, what is the power in the name of Jesus and how to apply into our life. And second, by his achievement or what he did, he got a great name. Ephesians chapter 1 verse 20 and 21. Here we find by what he had done, he obtained a great name.
Which he wrought in Christ when he raised him from the dead and set him at his own right hand in the heavenly places, far above all principality and power and might and dominion and every name that is named, not only in this world, but also in that which is to come.
So at resurrection, what happened that his name, he received a name above all principality and power. That means all the demonic powers, he got a great name. By death, he conquered death. He conquered all the demons and rose up on the third day after death. So he got a great name. And the third is that he was conferred, he was given a great name. That already we read in Philippians chapter 2, 9 to 11, already we read that. He was given a name far above all other names. So beloved ones, all the blessings from salvation to rapture, all are deposited in one sense in the name of Jesus. So if we don't know the power of the name of Jesus, our Christian life can be almost empty and very dry. See, how are we saved? How are we saved? How are we born again? John chapter 1 verse 12 says, John 1:12.
But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them which that believe on his name.
See, those who believe on his name, they are given power. It doesn't say those who believe on him, power is given. Power means authority and power against all the foul spirits. So salvation itself is when we believe on the name of on his name, we are saved. Not only saved, given his power. Power shows that authority and power. You exercise power against all the powers of darkness. When I was working in a particular place, one of the ones who was coming to church, his daughter was a young girl, a beautiful Christian she was. As she was coming out of the railway station, one pickpocket came and snatched away her wallet. The crowd found her to be like a daredevil. She was very bold. You know what did she do? She turned around, taking few steps towards the thief, the pickpocket. She loudly told, "In the name of Jesus, I command you to leave the wallet and go." The man got scared and threw the wallet and ran off. Next Sunday, the father gave the testimony how what the daughter had done. Many children of God are like chicken. If we don't know the power in the name of Jesus, I tell you, the word of God says there is tremendous power in the name of Jesus. God hath highly exalted him, given him a name which is above every name. All the demons, it's only a name. Only just a name. All the sicknesses are just a name. All the pains and fears, all are just a name. None of them have enough power to come anywhere near to the name of Jesus. Father given him a name above every name. At the name of Jesus, every knee should bow. It is, remember, it is at the name of Jesus. At the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. Dear child of God, do you really exercise that power in the name of Jesus? We would like to hear some testimonies about the victorious life. How Jesus makes our life victorious. What is the power in the name of Jesus? Once there was an open air meeting going on. The man of God was speaking about the power in the name of Jesus. And one man was far away walking across the road or near that place. He was carrying a knife. He was on the way to kill his unfaithful wife. As he was passing that way, he heard the power in the name of Jesus. The man of God was exalting the power in the name of Jesus. He felt a power came and arrested that man. Literally, he felt near a lamppost. He felt tied to the lamppost. He couldn't move from there. As the name of Jesus was preached, the heavenly power came, went into him and arrested him there. Spiritually. He couldn't move. Then and there he accepted the Lord Jesus Christ. And God changed him. Then and there he forgave his wife. And became a beautiful man of God. Obviously, wife also turned to Christ. I ask you, do you know the power in the mighty name of Jesus on the resurrection morning? The Father had highly exalted him. In all these three ways, Jesus received a great name. By inheritance, he received the great name. By his achievement on the cross, accomplished what he accomplished, he received a great name. And Father gave him a great name. And at the name of Jesus, every knee of every demon, every power of sickness, every power of the hell and enemy must bow. I want you, please read the Bible wherever the name of the Lord is mentioned. I tell you, they are tremendous in the Old Testament and New Testament too. I want to take only some selected Bible verses. But I tell you, it can really transform your life and my life. As I told you, those who knew the wonderful, excellent name of Jesus, they became great saints. They were able to conquer death. fear of death, fear of sickness. They lived an overcoming life. And they swallowed up death in victory. Beloved ones, this is so great. Let me take one Old Testament verse about it. It's well known to all of us. Psalm 91 verse 14. Because he has set his love upon me, therefore will I deliver him. I will set him on high because he had known my name. Psalm 91:14. I will set him on high because he hath known my name. Do you know him? Do you know his name? His name is excellent. His oil is like ointment poured forth. His name is all the more glorious. When you take that name, you are, in fact, you are already given the name. It is tremendous, dear children of God. We must realize and we must know that. When we know the power in the name of Jesus and we use it, all the demons have to bow. Suppose there is a traffic policeman standing there. He may be a bankrupt, a poor man. He may have hardly anything at home. But when he is in the uniform, when he stands controlling the traffic, when he raises the red sign stop, what will happen to the all the whatever Cadillac or whatever cars, what will happen? It may be the governor in the car or whoever may be in the car. When the traffic policeman will raise that sign with the uniform there and that sign stop, then what happens to all those vehicles? They all stop. It's not because this man is richer than the people, those who are in the Cadillac. It is not so. It is not this man has got more muscles than the people, those who are inside the vehicles. It is not because this man is stronger than all the engines of those vehicles. Why all the vehicles are stopping? Anybody may answer? Yes, exactly. This man is given authority and power. And they have to honor it. In case any drunkard fellow will overtake and go, he may crash against another vehicle and collide and finished. This man is given power and authority. Dear child of God, you are that traffic policeman. You have that red sign before you. Demons all bow down now. They all have to bow down. Because you have been given that authority and power in the name of Jesus. Shall we praise God that we are heavenly traffic policemen? Shall we praise God for that? Hallelujah. Amen. Praise ye Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This name is the part of our life now. How this name has come to us? Because Christ is the head and church is the body. You will not call the head Brother Dennis and body Brother Henry, you don't call. If head you call Brother Dennis, you call the body also Brother Dennis, isn't it? Christ is the head and church, the body also then part of that head. So that name is given to us. We become part and parcel of that name or body. We are given this name. Oh, this name does so much. Read one verse in New Testament, that is one favorite verse of mine also, John chapter 14, verse 14. 13 and 14. John chapter 14, 13 and 14.
And whatsoever ye shall ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If ye shall ask anything in my name, I will do it.
In both places, beloved ones, my name is mentioned. You shall ask anything in my name. Whatsoever you shall ask in my name. It is taking the name of Jesus and asking anything in my name. I will do it. Actually, the Greek, although I don't know the Greek, saints say it is a very strong word. It can be paraphrased this way. If you ask anything in my name, even if I don't have one, I will make one and give to you. Suppose you see that blue moon in the sky. Lord, you pray. I'm just telling an example. Lord, I am not satisfied with this blue moon. I need a green moon. What does the Bible say here? If you ask anything in my name. No, some of the things will be hard for me. Does it say? If you ask anything in my name, I will do it. Lord, I need a green moon. In Jesus' name. Then what will the Lord do for us? I know nobody will ask for that. But I'm just giving an illustration. Then the Lord will give the blue moon, rather green moon. Why? Because He promised anything you ask in my name, I will do it. If I don't have one, I will make one. Once a saint prayed for a man who did not have eyeballs. His name, I don't know, still alive. His name is George, somewhere in South India. God created two eyes, eyeballs. And if my memory is correct, he will go to the stage in so many conventions and will have a needle and a thread, and he will be able to insert the thread into the needle. If in my name, ask anything in my name, I will do it. In the name of Jesus, we find it washes our sins, it sanctifies. Then please read 1 Corinthians 6:11. Quickly, I have to mention because quite a number of our dear ones have to go in a few minutes' time. 1 Corinthians 6:11. Then I will quickly go to, there are three steps how to use this name.
And such were some of you, but ye are washed, but ye are sanctified, but ye are justified in the name of the Lord Jesus and by the Spirit of our God.
Praise be to God. Here, you are washed, you are sanctified, you are justified in the name of the Lord. So in the name of Jesus, there is washing, there is sanctification, and there is also justification. Now let me come to the three simple steps how to use this great name. How many of you really want to use the name of Jesus? Hands up. Raise the hands and praise God. You believe that today God will help us. From today, God will help us. There are three simple steps. All God's ways are very simple. First step, you must be a child of God. As many as received Him, to them He gave power to become the sons of God. Today, if you are not a child of God, today you receive Jesus into your heart. Or if you are gone away from the Lord, you come back to the Lord. Receive Him back into your heart. And the second step, please listen carefully. You should not have any unconfessed sin in your life. If you keep unconfessed sin in your life, don't take the name. That name will be so many ways nowadays. This area, so many Christians, they don't want to make their life right. I think last week in particular church, and a servant of God corrected a girl who had gone for a movie. I understand the name of the movie was Titanic. You know what she replied back? I watched worse movies than that. Compared to her standard, this was nothing. Oh, there is a generation, Bible says, there is a generation in whose eyes everything is pure, clean. In a particular church, one of our churches, who is a believer in a prominent position, doing some important ministries. Wife went and confessed to the minister, "My husband is a hypocrite. He does so much of ministry in the church. How many times he beats me up. And he has warned me, if you go and tell the ministers, I will finish you up." And they come to church and go to the bottomless pit after dying. They may have a good name in the church, but living as hypocrites. So we servants of God also cannot do anything. Because if we will go and ask that believer may go and beat up more. I don't know how many people like that seated here. This morning a telephone call came from another church, a servant of God told. He told last night he had a vision about a dream about the terrible judgment of God coming upon God's people. So many people were like Sodom and Gomorrah, and brimstone and fire came and destroyed and burned so many. In some places, almost all were destroyed. Nowadays, Christians are, I'm not telling everyone, very indifferent to when it comes to living a transparent life. Now people have got videos and televisions, any type of movie, they don't need to go to the movie theater, they can watch at home. And come and take Holy Communion also. But in the beginning of the ministry it was not so. As Jesus was told in the, you know, why don't Moses had suffered, permitted divorce, why don't you permit it to Jesus when he was told that? Jesus told, because of the hardness of your heart, only Moses permitted it. But in the beginning it was not so. In the beginning of the church it was not so. Those who watch movies, they were put out of the church. I remember that many years ago, one of our believers, who was just a teenage boy, where he, while walking close to the cinema theater, he was curiously looking at the posters, billboards there. Somebody else went and told the servant of God. And before that he was disciplined. Now I tell you, he's in a particular church, he's a real saint. Now what is today's standard? So many had so much of filth coming through computer and television, so much of pornographic things. And they don't confess. Bible says that he that covereth his sin shall not prosper. He that confesseth and forsaketh shall have mercy. It doesn't say just to forsake, no. Confession needed. One man, young man the other day asked, why should I come and confess to anyone of you? Why can't I confess to God? Look at the word of God from beginning to the end. David was a man of God. He had such a close relationship with God. Look at Psalm 23 and so many other psalms he read there. Was it not a spiritual man? But when he committed sin, what happened? God sent a servant of God and go and speak to him. Let him confess to you. David could have told, I will confess to God. No, he had to confess to that man of God. When Achan sinned against God, what did Joshua say? Confess to God and confess to me. What does the New Testament say? When you are sick, that is not only physically, when you are spiritually sick also. Call the elders and then confess one to another. Not don't call somebody from the street and confess, no. Oh, if you want to hide sin, you will find some excuses. But I tell you, you will not be able to take the name of the Lord. When you have unconfessed sins, when you take the name of the Lord, that will burn you. But as you take the name of the Lord, having been washed in the blood of Jesus and cleansed, oh, there is untold blessings there, the beloved ones. He got a great name, far above all other names. At the name of Jesus, every demon has to bow. Every sickness has to bow. Every pain has to go. We have a sister in Madras, Adia. She is so thin. It may appear like if you blow, she may fall down. One day as she was going from the faith home for a visiting, a ferocious dog, somebody was walking the dog, and a ferocious dog just jumped over her. She, guess what did she do? In the name of Jesus, I rebuke you. It, all the four legs, the right was creeping on the floor. The owner came, what did you do to my dog? Because it was almost dead. It took some time to come out of the shock. As if suddenly somebody shot her there, he just fell down. She was such a thin sister. But there is a great name. You are the traffic policeman. You have been given that name. The name above every name. From today, will you take the name of Jesus and use it? And the third thing to know, first we told you, you must be a child of God. Second thing, there should not be any unconfessed sins. Even if you are touched to somebody with the wrong desire, intention, you must go and confess to some mature Christian or servant of God. If you hide any sin, Jesus has nothing to do with you. You will be a miserable creature. You may live miserably and die miserably. No, beloved ones, we are not called to that stage. Oh, there is tremendous power in the name of Jesus. What is the third thing? Third thing, we should know and believe the wonderful power in the name of Jesus. If you don't know what is the power in the name of Jesus, you may never use it. You may have $1 million in bank, but if you don't know that your father left that money, you may die as a pauper and die in poverty and starvation. So to use that name, we must know the power in that name. It, one man of God says, it is like the power of atoning. The name of Jesus is like the power of atoning. Suppose I have a father who is a multi-millionaire. He has given me the power of atoning. Means he has given his name in a sense. On behalf of him, I can sign. All the property, disposing or selling or getting or anything, all of them belong to my father. But I am given the authority and power. That is what the lawyers called the power of atoning. The name of Jesus is the power of atoning given to us. Oh, beloved ones, it is not worth keeping any secret sins. If you have cheated someone, if you have taken a book from a library in a cheating way, or from a shop something by mistake, even $1 that you have cheated, we must make restitution. When we take the name of Jesus, our heart should not have any unconfessed secret sins. The name of Jesus, the name also means character. Name in the Bible, one meaning is character. So we must grow in the knowledge or character of Jesus. God is humble. Every day we must pray, Lord, I want to become humble like God is holy. Lord, none of us are holy like Jesus. I am far short of that. But we must say, Lord, I want to become like you. Name has got two aspects. One is power or authority, what we call. Another is name is the character. So as we take the name of Jesus, we will grow in the divine character. And also we will be growing the divine power. These two should go together. We must not keep anything that we know that we are guilty of. We must confess and repent. Then the power of Jesus will become so great. While closing, let me tell you, there are so many verses I mentioned here, but I have no time to mention because time is up. But let me conclude saying, all the blessings are deposited in the bank called the name of Jesus. So when we take the name of Jesus, with the key we are opening all the blessings of God. All the power and authority in the name of Jesus. Demons' powers are really shaken. And we can live free from fear of sin and fear of sickness and death. Oh, we can live a life pleasing to God. In my name they shall lay the hand on the sick. Silver and gold have I none, but what I have, I give you. In the name of Jesus of Nazareth, rise up and walk. It is because he has known my name, I will set him on high. Today, dear precious child of God, it is not worth keeping any sin in your life. Oh, we all may make mistakes. This morning also I made a mistake. I realized I irritated somebody. But the next minute I used the phone and apologized to that person. Sorry for irritating you. Although I didn't mean, but it happened. So mistakes may happen, but we can come to the Lord. There is power in the blood of Jesus to wash all our sins. There is power in the precious blood of Jesus. And there is wonderful power in the name of Jesus. His name is called Excellent Name. It is told about a saint. He wanted to pray for a dying man. One man called Lazarus was dying of tuberculosis. They all prayed, nothing happened. Suddenly that man of God called Smith Wigglesworth, he felt to take the name of Jesus. There were seven people with him. They all were told, let us exalt the name of Jesus. They all started taking the name of Jesus, the name of Jesus, the great name of Jesus. They all started praising and worshipping. That man's skin and bone, he was dying of TB. As they took the name of Jesus, power started coming upon him. Within a short time, within few hours within a short time that day, he rose up from the bed, completely healed. The name of Jesus had done that. Shall we all stand up? Jesus was risen. He is exalted far above heavens. By death and resurrection, he conquered death and hell and sin and sickness and all the powers of hell he conquered. Beloved ones, that name is given. Oh, there's in Revelation it's written that I will give a new name, unknown to others. Today, how many of you want to have this name in your life? How many of you really want to have this name in your life? This name can protect you even at the moment of your death. If the Lord tarries, I tell you, if you keep your life without any secret sin, your life will be glorious. Your death will be more glorious. Your eternity will be most glorious. Only three things we need to do. First, we must be children of God. I believe all of us are children of God. Second thing, don't keep any unconfessed sin in your life and my life. Third thing, know the power in the name of Jesus and the power in the character of Jesus. With this, we are in victory, on victory ground. As I invite the singers to come and sing, be ready today. Lord, I am a traffic policeman in the Lord's kingdom. You have given me power and authority. Jesus, while sending the disciples, go and preach. But in my name, baptize them. In the name of Jesus, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Oh, everywhere it is the name of Jesus. It is the name of Jesus. Before the singers come to sing, shall we exalt the name of Jesus? Shall we praise God for the wonderful power in the name of Jesus? Shall we praise God for the excellent name of Jesus? Shall we praise God because there is power in the name of Jesus? Hallelujah! 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 Hallelujah!
Power in the name of Jesus. We have power, power, power in Jesus' name. Every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. The King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Son of Righteousness. Hell is trembling at the strength we possess. We have power, power, power in Jesus' name. Power, power in the name of Jesus. We have power, power, power in Jesus' name. Every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. The King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Son of Righteousness. Hell is trembling at the strength we possess. We have power, power, power in Jesus' name. On the cross he died, shamed and crucified. Was hope gone for the blind and the lame? No, but Christ did rise, came and dwelt inside, filling disciples with power in his name. We have power, power in the name of Jesus. We have power, power, power in Jesus' name. Every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. The King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Son of Righteousness. Hell is trembling at the strength we possess. We have power, power, power in Jesus' name.
You don't want to delay, but I realize there is the power of the presence of God is here this afternoon. In the name of Jesus, you are free. Because the name of Jesus has been approved and accepted by heaven. As you take the name of Jesus, sickness has to go. Fear of every power of the enemy must go. Your pain has to go. Your worry has to go. Your worry. Anything that is of the devil must go.
Todo lo que sea del diablo se tiene
I
que
tell
ir.
You, this is the greatest power.
Y le digo que este es el gran poder.
The power in the name of Jesus.
El poder en el nombre de
As
Jesús.
We continue to sing.
Mientras seguimos cantando.
Today, please experience and enjoy the privileges through the power
Hoy
of Jesus.
Experimente y goces en el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
En el nombre de Jesús.
Rise up and walk.
Levántese y camine.
In the name of Jesus.
En el nombre de
Be
Jesús.
Healed.
Sea sanado.
In the name of Jesus.
En el nombre de Jesús.
Receive the power of God.
Recibe el poder de Dios.
As we are singing.
Mientras cantamos.
May I request to all of you to please leave the chairs and come over
todos,
and stand.
Dejen sus asientos y vengan
Today,
acá frente.
On this resurrection morning.
En este domingo de resurrección.
Let us exalt the name of Jesus.
Vamos a exaltar el nombre de
the
Jesús.
The name that Father has already honored.
El nombre que Dios ha dado sobre
Three ways Jesus received a great name.
De tres maneras él recibió ese
By
nombre
By inheritance he received great name.
recibió el nombre grande.
By his accomplishment
también
he received
por lo
great
que logró
name.
En la cruz, él recibió
and
su gran nombre.
Great name is conferred to him.
Y también un gran nombre le
come
ha sido dado.
Come on, quickly and stand in the
vamos
presence of God.
Y parémonos en la
let
presencia
us put
de Dios.
The devil to shame today.
Vamos a poner al diablo en vergüenza.
Oh, please, beloved ones, take the name of Jesus and go from here.
Que usted tome el nombre de Jesús y vaya de aquí.
Don't keep any secret sins.
No tenga ningún pecado
today
en secreto.
Today itself and confess and forsake.
Hoy es el día de confesar y de abandonar.
Shall we sing unto
vamos a cantar al Señor.
Power in the name of Jesus. We have power, power, power in Jesus' name. Every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. The King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Son of Righteousness. Hell is trembling at the strength we possess. We have power, power, power in Jesus' name. We have power, power in the name of Jesus. We have power, power, power in Jesus' name. Every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. The King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Son of Righteousness. Hell is trembling at the strength we possess. We have power, power, power in Jesus' name. We have power, power in the name of Jesus. We have power, power, power in Jesus' name. Every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. The King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Son of Righteousness. Hell is trembling at the strength we possess. We have power, power, power in Jesus' name.
We have power,
power in the name of Jesus. We have power, power, power in Jesus' name. Every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. The King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Son of Righteousness. Hell is trembling at the strength we possess. We have power, power, power in Jesus' name. We have power, power in the name of Jesus. We have power, power, power in Jesus' name. Every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess. The King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Son of Righteousness. Hell is trembling at the strength we possess. We have power, power, power in Jesus' name.
We
have power, power in the name of Jesus. We have power, power, power in Jesus' name. Every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess. The King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Son of Righteousness. Hell is trembling at the strength we possess. We have power, power, power in Jesus' name.
We
have power, power in the name of Jesus. We have power, power, power in Jesus' name. Every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess. The King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Son of Righteousness. Hell is trembling at the strength we possess. We have power, power, power in Jesus' name.
We have power,
power in the name of Jesus. We have power, power, power in Jesus' name. Every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. The King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Son of Righteousness. Hell is trembling at the strength we possess. We have power, power, power in Jesus' name.
We have power,
power in the name of Jesus. We have power, power, power in Jesus' name. Every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. The King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Son of Righteousness. Hell is trembling at the strength we possess. We have power, power, power in Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus, we have the victory.
Hallelujah.
In the name of
Jesus, in the name of Jesus,
demons will have to flee. We will tell what God has done. Mighty battles he has won. In the name of Jesus,
Jesus,
we have the victory. Oh yes! In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we have the victory.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, demons will have to flee. We will tell what God has done, mighty battles he has won. In the name of Jesus,
Jesus, we have the victory.
In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we have the victory.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, demons will have to flee. We will tell what God has done. Mighty battles he has won. In the name of Jesus, we have the victory. Oh, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we have the victory.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we must will have to flee. We will tell what God has done. Mighty battles he has won. In the name of Jesus,
oh, yes.
Jesus,
we have the victory.
Oh, yes.
In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we have the victory.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, demons will have to flee. We will tell what God has done. Mighty battles he has won. In the name of Jesus, Jesus, we have the victory. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we have the victory. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we must will have to flee. We will tell what God has done. Mighty battles he has won. In the name of Jesus, Jesus, we have the victory. We will tell what God has done. Mighty battles he has won. In the name of Jesus,
Jesus,
we have the victory. Oh, we will tell what God has done. Mighty battles he has won. In the name of
Jesus,
we have the victory. Oh, we will tell what God has done. Mighty battles he has won. In the name of
Jesus,
we will tell what God has done. Mighty battles he has won. In the name of
Jesus,
we have the
el nombre de Jesús.
Don't let the devil frighten you.
No deje que el diablo le tormente y le traiga miedo sin
necesidad.
Si usted hoy hace esta decisión,
Lord, I will not keep any secret.
No voy a guardar ningún pecado secreto.
Anything God will show, I will surely confess.
Todo lo que Dios muestre lo voy a confesar y lo voy a abandonar.
Yes, you can take the name today.
Usted puede entonces
take
tomar el nombre
the name of Jesus now.
Tome el nombre de Jesús.
You'll be healed today.
Usted va a ser sanado
hoy. Let your pain go.
De todo dolor
you tenga. Exercise the power
against
the devil.
El poder del nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
En el nombre de Jesús.
You rebuke the devil.
Usted reprende
in
el diablo.
In the name of Jesus.
En el nombre de Jesús.
You rebuke sickness.
Reprenda toda
in
enfermedad.
In the name of Jesus.
En el nombre de Jesús.
You rebuke the pain.
Reprenda la,
in
el dolor.
In the name of Jesus.
En el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
En el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
En el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
En el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
En el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
En el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
En el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
En el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
En el nombre de Jesús.
Aleluya.
Amén.
Aleluya. 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 Oh, glory, glory, glory. Glory, 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 glory. Everyone open the mouth. Everyone open the mouth.
Todo, abra su boca.
Don't be afraid of the devil.
No tenga temor al diablo.
He that is in you is greater than he that is in you.
Usted más poderoso que es que está allá afuera.
God has given you that. Use that name.
Dios le ha dado que usted pueda usar ese nombre.
God has given you power and authority to use the name.
Dios le ha dado autoridad y poder para usar.
Now open your mouth.
Ahora abra su
open
boca.
Open your heart.
Abra su corazón.
You command in the name of Jesus.
Usted manda en el nombre de
whatever
Jesús.
Sickness you have.
Cualquier enfermedad que usted
you
tenga.
You command in the name of
usted
Jesus.
Usted manda en el nombre de Jesús
you
que se vaya.
That, name of that sickness.
Usted tome el nombre de esa
cancer
enfermedad.
Is only a name.
El cáncer es solamente una enfermedad.
Reumatismo
es un nombre.
Is only a name.
Cualquiera que sea solamente
at
un nombre.
The name of Jesus.
Pero en el nombre de Jesús.
Cataract has to go.
Todo eso se tiene que ir.
Has to go.
El cáncer se tiene que ir.
Has to go.
El reumatismo se
pain
tiene que
has
ir.
To go.
Todo dolor que
you
va.
Must take the name of
usted
Jesus
debe
now.
Tomar el nombre
shall
de Jesús.
We use the name of Jesus
vamos
now.
A usar el nombre de Jesús.
Aleluya.
Oh,
yes, oh God. Sit up, get up. In the name of Jesus. I command you to leave. Aleluya. In the name of Jesus. Aleluya. 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 Oh, glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Aleluya. Aleluya. Let us lift up the hands and praise God. In the name of Jesus, we have victory.
Vamos a darle gracias al Señor porque en el nombre de Jesús tenemos victoria.
Aleluya.
Aleluya. Aleluya.
Aleluya.
Aleluya. Gracias, Señor.
Aleluya.
Gracias, Señor.
Aleluya.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you. And to leave this place.
Mientras hoy nos vamos de este lugar.
I request you. Any time, any sudden fear is going to come.
Si algún temor repentino viene.
Immediately you take the name of Jesus.
Inmediatamente tome el nombre de Jesús.
You never know what is in this world.
Usted no sabe lo que hay en este mundo esperándole.
But carry the name of Jesus.
Pero siempre tome el, lleve el nombre de Jesús.
That is the greatest power in heaven and hell and on earth.
Es el nombre más poderoso en los cielos,
so,
en la tierra y en el infierno.
Please take the name of Jesus and go.
Tome el nombre de Jesús y vaya.
In every situation, take the name of Jesus.
En cualquier situación, tome el nombre de Jesús.
That name has been approved.
Ese nombre ha sido aprobado.
The power of attorney is given to us.
El poder de abogado le ha sido
let's all once again praise God.
Vamos a alabar otra vez
Aleluya.
A Dios.
Amén, Señor. Praise oh, God. Praise God. God. Keep praising God. Keep praising God. Keep praising God. Aleluya. 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 Aleluya.
Jesus, in Jesus' name, come.
In Jesus' name. 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 You may be wondering why I'm delayed. There are some people really bound by demons. The word of God has not gone to them at all. They are really covered with ugly, dirty, sinful clouds. The devil says, don't believe this message. The devil says, at least one person here, the devil says, this message is not for you.
Por lo menos a una persona el diablo le está diciendo, ese mensaje no es para ti.
I bound you forever.
Yo te he atado para siempre.
You come, not come out of it.
Y tú nunca saldrás de eso.
The devil says, you have gone too far in sin.
El diablo le ha dicho, tú has ido muy profundo en el pecado. Has cometido tantos pecados.
Jesus' name cannot do anything
por eso que ya el nombre de Jesús no puede hacer nada.
I tell you, devil is a liar.
Le digo que el diablo es mentiroso.
Jesus is true.
Jesús es la verdad.
He has power to deliver you today.
Tiene poder para libertarle
hoy.
He has
power to bring you out of darkness.
Él tiene poder para traerle de las tinieblas.
Those dirty sins God wants to wash you today.
Todos esos pecados ocultos y sucios, el Señor le quiere lavar. Él le quiere lavar.
If the Son makes you free, you will be free indeed.
Si el Hijo libertare, seréis verdaderamente libres.
All those who love the name of Jesus.
Todos los que amen el nombre de Jesús.
I request you. At least there is one person here like that.
Si hay una persona así hoy,
shall we really take up the name of Jesus?
Vamos a tomar el nombre de Jesús.
That person should come out of darkness today.
Que esa persona salga de las tinieblas hoy.
That person's hands and feet are bound by the devil.
Que los pies y las manos están atados.
Darkness is all over the place.
Las tinieblas están sobre todo el lugar.
Head to foot.
Desde tu coronilla
but
hasta la
Jesus
planta de los pies.
Come to free.
Pero Jesús ha venido a libertarle.
All the children of God.
Le pido a todos los hijos
shall
de Dios.
Pray.
Vamos ahora.
Let the power of devil be released.
Que el poder del diablo sea suelto.
Let that person come out now.
Y esa persona salga.
In the name of Jesus.
En el nombre de Jesús. Aleluya.
No. In the name of
oh,
Jesus.
Padre Santo, en el nombre de Jesús.
You
no.
Are
oh, Padre Santo. Diablo, tú no
in
tienes poder.
Tú
no puedes atar a esa persona porque
in
el nombre de Jesús.
Jesus.
En el nombre de Jesús,
en
el nombre de Jesús, sal, sal, demonio de mentira, sal, oh, demonio de mentira, sea, en el nombre de Jesús, sea ahí, es el hijo, la hija de Dios, oh, tú no tienes poder en esta criatura, aleluya,
oh,
en el nombre de Jesús, en el nombre de Jesús, estás suelto,
estás
libertado, aleluya,
en el nombre de Jesús. Sé libertad en el nombre de Jesús.
Aleluya.
Aleluya. Aleluya. Aleluya.
Oh, Señor.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, glory. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Ahora, Señor. Derrota en el nombre de Jesús. Oh, Jesus.
Aleluya.
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 Aleluya. En el nombre de Jesús,
en el nombre de Jesús, Señor.
Oh, Padre. Aleluya. 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 Oh, no, mi. Oh. Gracias. 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 Oh, your name is wonderful.
name of Jesus. Name of Jesus. Name of Jesus.
Hallelujah. Amen, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Solamente quería cerrar el servicio, pero algo Dios quería.
It is possible at least some of you may face a temptation today.
Es posible que muchos de ustedes pasen por una tentación.
A trial today.
Una prueba hoy.
Or a sickness situation today.
O una enfermedad tal vez.
Or something a fearful situation today.
O una situación de temor hoy.
But you must go prepared today.
Pero hoy váyase preparado.
It may not be everyone in the assembly.
Tal vez no sean todos en la
asamblea. Perhaps some of you.
Tal vez algunos.
Today the Spirit of God is telling you.
Pero hoy el Espíritu de Dios dice.
My child, you must take my name and
go. Mi hijo, toma mi nombre y ve.
You will be protected.
Tú serás protegido.
That time you may not be able to give a call to the faithful.
Tal vez en ese tiempo no pueda llamar al hogar de fe.
That moment immediately you must take the name
Pero
of Jesus.
Pero en ese momento.
Shall we take the name of Jesus and go?
Vamos a tomar el nombre de Jesús.
Shall we praise God for the name of Jesus?
Vamos a alabar a Dios por el nombre de Jesús.
Aleluya.
Aleluya.
Aleluya. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Yes, oh God! Yes, Lord! Thank you, Jesus! Thank you, Jesus! Thank you, Jesus! Our loving Heavenly Father, we praise and thank you for this most blessed moments you have given on this resurrection morning. Because you, Lord, died on the cruel cross and buried and raised. Father, oh, what a great name. Your name has been exalted far above all heavens at the name of Jesus. Every knee shall bow. Thank you, Father. That wonderful, excellent name is given to us. We became part of that name. Hallelujah. Help all thy children till the rapture or till the last breath to realize the tremendous power in the name of Jesus. And Lord, go in that power. Let sickness, weakness, pain, Lord, worry, care, anxiety, everything be under our feet, O God, because your name is above all. Father, once again,